I saw this coming for Nahshon when he started at Oregon State. A lot of people aren't aware that Nahshon, well, they probably are now, but prior to Nahshon was a receiver. And once he began to play corner at Laney, I saw him actually making it as a corner in the league. And then when he went to Oregon, I really saw it. He had a couple of interceptions, a lot of pass breakups, and he was on an island by himself. A lot of the teams hesitated to go to his side of the ball. So that's when I kind of was like, wow, he could really do this. Their feel for of going to his side. And some teams did, but by the second or third time, most of the time, it was an interception.
Nahshon Wright, a big corner.
That's a 6'4" corner. Scouts drool when they see a body like that.
6'4", 190 out of East Palo Alto.
Gotta be the odds, I'm trying to blend in. Hit that boy so many times, he may see it.
Nahshon Wright comes up with the Beavers turnover.
Put up in the whole school to fit me in the rear end, big dog. Taking chances, getting packs and trying to get them back. I watched the law take my bro
and it's intercepted at midfield by Nahshon Wright.
What's the chances that you run you up
just
a couple
too
mil?
Much physicality from Wright.
What's the chances that you run you up a couple mil? And you two man catch your body. I got it the worst. I had the real.
Comes right and the ball comes out. Nahshon Wright is the man who knocked it.
Six figures still got sheets. Curtains, excuse me, I go off half fast, press my purses. I'm telling you, I got it the worst.
My name is Nahshon Wright. I play defensive back for Oregon State University. I'm from East Palo Alto, California. So coming from East Palo Alto and making it this far, definitely a big deal, just because when people hear of East Palo Alto, they don't think of opportunity, someone making it out, especially this far. So to have gotten this far is definitely a blessing. It's definitely an eye opener. It should be an eye opener to a lot of people that there is talent there, that there is people that are working. And it's no different than any other city. There's good, there's just bad. So it's definitely a blessing to have gotten this far out of East Palo Alto, knowing just that stigma that's placed on the city of East Palo Alto. So yeah. I first started playing sports when I was 7 years old. My mom and father got me into track. I ran track for the East Palo Alto Greyhounds. So track was my first sport. And then as I got older, I got introduced to football a year later. And then just been tracking football since then. What I've been working on since I've entered the draft is, of course, my strength and conditioning, improving my football IQ. And then the technical things of playing the DB position. So working on my footwork, my press, my off coverage, stuff like that. In terms of doing more, I feel like there's always more that can be done, but for the short time that I did have, I feel like I touched on almost everything that I could have. So my speed, my strength, my conditioning, and then of course, like my 40, broad jump, stuff like that. Yeah, growing up, I never had intentions of being a DB. It just kind of happened. For me, I just wanted to play football. So regardless if it was quarterback, receiver, running back, hell, lineman, if I did gain some weight. But yeah.
Let's go to the show!
You're right. We don't be on social sites.
Three, take him in there.
Get up.
Four. Breathe with it.
That's it. It's like after three, that missed.
That's where you gotta add all those people. Both of you guys gotta add some chunks. So like with you, 1, 3, 8, take a couple seconds, and then you gotta think in your head, I gotta get two. Pop, pop. Breathe, pop, pop. Once you get to three, then you gotta take one rep. Down. Breathe, down, pop. Does that make sense?
It feels lighter, like I can go.
What makes me different than other corners, I mean, is the obvious. I'm 6'4". There's not a lot of people that are 6'4". So I'm long and athletic. I have great ball skills. I feel like my ball skills are above average. And not too many can say that at the defensive back position. And I'm able to slow the game down. I'm able to see formations, splits, and kind of take what I've learned from the film to the grass. Going to the NFL changed my life drastically. It's a lifelong dream of mine. So just getting there would be crazy. And then at some point I get to a point where I can take care of my family and be that provider for my family, and just be an inspiration of the youth. So I feel like that in terms of that, that's how it changed my life. Losing my father, in terms of how it changed my mental state and like just the way how I move, is just it just taught me not to take life for granted, or the people or the things you love for granted, and to cherish every moment you get with your people or on the field or whatnot. Not to complain, because I mean, you never know like when it'll be your last day, whether it's on the field or your last day seeing someone. So, it made me mature. I feel like I kind of had to take on a father figure role for my younger brother, and kind of just stepping up and making sure that he was straight in terms of school, football, just stuff like that. And it's motivated me. Now I just kind of have this constant chip on my shoulder just to be great. Just because I know what my dad wanted from me, and that was just to be the best version of me. So each day I'm pushing to be 1% better, to make my dad happy, make my dad proud, because this is what he wanted from me. So I'm just constantly grinding.
Yes,
man. Where you at? Bushing. Bullshit. Kelly. Can you get it in? Yeah, I'm gonna do a little bit. I can't do too much.
What you gonna do after?
Shit, we're going to AJ's, I think. Alright, I'm
gonna come
out there. Alright. People gonna fire, man.
650 Dream Team is something that my brothers and my cousins and I started. And it's just a way of kind of giving back. It's our positive outreach to the youth and just showing them that it can be done. Just because where we come from, there's a lot of talent. And we all went the JUCO route, being under-recruited, or for me, in my case, didn't have the right amount of core classes. So we all had to go to JUCO route, and we all made it to Division I, and I'm here now, and they should be on their way next. So this is just our way of just kind of giving back, just showing kids it can be done.
But it's hella hot.
Not even that hot.
Crazy.
Yeah,
he's done. He's over with.
I was first.
Nah, he gonna stop what he's talking about, dude.
What's up, kid?
Yeah, call that ass brother and shit.
I don't know about that. He, I think he's still in Oakland.
Up like the generation kind of older than us, there's only a select few that really one that I can think of that really got this far and kind of showed that it can be done, which is Keyshawn. So seeing him do it for us was kind of like we can do it too. So as long as you kind of have that right mindset and you're doing something positive with your life, you gotta have that right mindset. You gotta have that dog mentality, and just kind of have that attitude, like never giving up, and just that continuous fight. Cause it's definitely a dog fight. Going Division One and having to win a battle every day, keeping your starter position every day, cause it's a man under you trying to get you. So you just gotta keep pushing. You gotta have that number two mindset. That's a mindset that I like to have, just because number two is always trying to beat number one. Often number one gets complacent. So you gotta have that number two mindset. Not just football players, just for anybody that's trying to get somewhere in life or obtain their dreams, is just to continue working and grinding, because it comes with ups and downs, and sometimes more downs than ups. So just keep pushing. Find a group of people who have the same type of mindset as you, who are gonna push you on a daily basis. I think that's what I did, and that's what helped me. I have my cast of people, Makai, Ray, AJ, Dejan, Davion. We just push each other daily.
Not that one.
What I personally am looking forward to seeing, what I want to see as him moving forward, is him just doing like a run back. Doing a run back, scoring a touchdown. That'd be tight.
Not bad for a 68-year-old man. Yeah.
My name is Earl Simon. I'm from out of East Palo Alto. I'm known in East Palo Alto as Earl of Pearl. What I think his draft prediction is going to be, I'm thinking, honestly, maybe late second round, late third. I would be really surprised if he dropped any lower than that. Well, it says I had a favorite team that I think he's going to go to. I prefer he goes to a 49er. I'm a Bay Area person. If he went to the Raiders, I think that's one of his favorite teams. I would be happy if he went to the Raiders. But like I say, I'm a 49er fan. But if he gets selected as a Raider, I will wear a Raider jersey.
Going into the draft, I didn't have any projections of what round I wanted to go, what team or whatnot. My thing is just getting my foot in the door. I think that's been my case my whole life, is just getting my foot in the door and having an opportunity. So just once I had an opportunity, I know that I'll take full advantage of it. Well, making it this far, knowing that there's millions of kids with the same dreams and aspirations as me is crazy. Because they say 1% make it this far. So to be amongst the 1% is crazy. This is what I expected, just because I put the time in, those countless hours when no one was watching, knowing that those sleepless nights when I was driving back and forth from Laney to my mom's house and getting homework done at 12 o'clock at night, and then having to get up at 5:30 and repeat my day over and over. So getting this far kind of makes all that worth it.
I know it starts Thursday.
Yeah.
Did they say your time yet?
3 o'clock.
Nahshon, late third round. That's my prediction, late third round. No lower than that.
Definitely not no lower than that. I agree. Follow me upstairs and I'll show you my man cave. So this is it, this is where I spend a lot of my time. Of course, I got my pictures on the wall that my grandson DeAndre did. My kids did all a painting of me. Of course, I got my grandson Ray shoes from Oregon State. Then I have the jersey that Nahshon had gave me. I had it framed. I'm awfully proud of them boys. Next jersey I put up here will be Ray's. When we go downstairs, I'll show you what my garage look like, and you'll see on the garage all the display I have of the boys. So follow me this way. So over here on the wall is all the displays and portraits. Nahshon and Ray. This is the big interception against Washington Huskies. This is the interception against Hawaii. This is Nahshon's first big hit in Division I against Oklahoma State. My favorite one is this one right here, where he's signing autographs for the kids at Cal Berkeley. That's huge. That's when I know he made it.
My name is Quady Simon. My relation to Nahshon Wright is he's my nephew and I'm his uncle. He would impact the NFL with his height, his speed, his hands. It helped with him running track, and that all goes into his position of where he's at on the field, and that plays a big factor into the game, and that's what the league needs, and he's going to represent that. I think his prediction is going to be late second, third round, for sure.
Do you have a team that you would like to see him go to?
Oh, I would love to personally see him on the Niners, but I'm happy to see him go anywhere in the league right now. It's more great to see somebody whose family on the field doing what they love and to do what you like to see, and not every day there's someone out there that can say that. So it's a blessing. Nahshon, I'm super proud of you. You've worked very hard to get to where you're at. Continue to keep pushing forward and doing what you need to do to keep growing and being better. And you have the mindset. I know you worked really hard to get here. Your dad will be very proud. Your mom's proud. We're all proud of you. I'm super happy for you. Let's get this. Let's get out there and keep doing what we do best. And I'm gonna be here always rooting for you. And I love you.
Okay. Let me get ready. So I put this on, right? Just in case I need to have this on. That's all I'm saying. Because if it goes down like this, make sure you have the camera on me right after you have it on him. If they say this, okay? That's all I need to do. That's it.
Hey, we got that blue on. We for them Cowboys.
You know what time it is.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
We are
yes.
So proud.
We're so proud of you, Nahshon. We're so proud.
I got a feeling, I'm telling you. And then they chose with their second or third. What's happening today? I've been told it's going to happen today. I think the Jets are the Cowboys.
You
know what I'm saying?
See what number
to?
This is?
See what number?
What team is he going to?
What team are you thinking?
Raiders.
The Raiders.
The Raiders.
On TV. You know.
They said he's going to the Raiders. Did you hear that?
What's his boy?
What team is he going to?
The Raiders.
Raiders.
Cowboys.
Representing, you know what I mean?
He going to the team.
Nobody's thinking about the Niners.
You know what I mean?
It's just me.
He want to win one. You know what I mean? He want to go somewhere where he can win one. He don't want to go somewhere that he just going to be recognized as a player. He want to go somewhere he can win one.
But what happens if Big Ben support?
Deshaun, man, I did this. I went through this process in 1993 when I got drafted to the Atlanta Falcons. But unfortunately, with that broken wrist, as a quarterback, being left-handed, it didn't happen. So I went the whole 3 days in this process, just like Deshaun, waiting to get my name called, and it didn't happen. But I was blessed to be able to go to the Atlanta Falcons in 1993. Jewel Jones, Jerry Glanville, Deion Sanders, me, all of us was on that roster. And so to be able to see my little Cuddy go through this right now, man, almost 28 years later, man, this is crazy. This is crazy, man. So you deserve this, man. It's all you, Nahshon. It's all to you. You put in the work. We love you.
Hey, this is my little cuz. You know, I'm happy for him. He's doing what he got to do. You know, we still got two more left coming up next. Somebody's going to get three outstanding young men.
We're going to be used to this. We've been through this. AJ and Ray, we're going to know how to handle it the second time around.
Yeah, second time around, we're going to do this a little,
We got our training wheels on now. But please believe me, next year, we're going to be handling it big time. We know how to handle it.
Yes, sir.
We got training wheels on now, but we about ready to take them off after the day. Earl of Pearl said so.
Why the Raiders is playing with us? Why is the Raiders playing? They picked a DP. What was they doing? What was going on with that? You know what? I haven't lost faith. I took my jacket off, but it's over there in my purse. And if I need to bring it back out, I'll bring it out. I got a Sharpie ready for him to sign it. So I'm ready.
Oh, for him to be a Raider?
I got my jacket over there.
Yeah.
She's ready too.
Yeah, I'm ready too. And I brought my jacket, you know, for him to sign right there.
Right.
And you know you can order the jersey, right after.
Oh,
they
really?
Drafted, yeah, because
oh, youngster, we, that's good. Yeah, we gonna get it. We gonna get it.
Yeah, because was that youngster?
We're gonna get it. We're gonna get it. But they gotta pick them. We gotta just go ahead and hurry up. They're playing games. You know, where's Mark? What's his name? Mark. Mark Davis.
Mark Davis.
Where's Mark Davis? We did a phone call into Mark. We been called Mark. We don't know what's going on.
Hi, Shani. It's tonight. It's going down tonight. Yes. Not tomorrow. But down.
We just hoping today. No, in the morning. Chilling.
Yes, it's nerve-wracking.
What they tried, they ain't got through yet. Raiders!
Lights guy from Blue Moon. Welcome to the light side of the moon.
If you would have had Ryan's number, you would have called too. I just never gave it to you.
They wanted them, but I know I've been bugging.
You would have called them every day.
I would have bugged the hell out. I'm glad you didn't. Everybody's calling me, man. I can't keep my phone charged.
It's gonna happen right now.
That was just momentarily. The pain that you went through, that happened last month, that happened last year, that happened last week. Listen, life is like football. You got to keep your chains moving. As long as you keep the chains moving, you got another first down. Got a couple more yards. Got a couple more yards. Got a first down again. Don't just keep worrying about the big touchdowns in life, because they're going to come. You got to keep the chains moving in life. I'm talking about every, listen, couple downs here, couple downs here. You might lose the ball in life. You might fall, but you get back up. You keep the chains moving, and you're going to win. And just like that.
I have to go. I have to go, dude. Yes, sir! Let's go! Let's get it!
I'm at home in Stockton, California. Yes.
Oh.
I'm doing good in yourself.
Let's go.
Thank you.
You got it. You got
Thank
it.
Thank you.
You got it, soldier. You got it, soldier. Got that. Please, please.
That's right, please, cousin. Please.
You
floor.
Got it, soldier.
Please. Go. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You got it,
soldier. Thank you. Thank you.
This is going to death!
2021 NFL Draft, the Dallas Cowboys select Nahshon Wright.
Yeah!
We going to Dallas, nigga!
Let's go, nigga!
I told you!
Let's go, nigga!
Let's go!
Oh, we going to Dallas, man!
Thank you, Dr. Him, Dr. Him,
what did I tell you?
Let's go, nephew!
He's doing it for his daddy, for the town. Picks. Oh my God. Oh my God, I knew it. I felt it in my heart. That's how I know God. I swear to God, I knew it. I felt it in my heart yesterday. Oh, if this ain't a revelation, man. Just believe, man. I follow your heart, man. Y'all just don't know how I felt today. Oh my God. We going to Cowboys, y'all. Boosters first, baby. That's what it is right now. That's the logo. Boosters first, baby.
In the fair, baby. Boosters
first. Hey, man, I love y'all. But I gotta rock with your team.
Being able to go in the third round is a blessing. From where I come from, it's definitely a huge accomplishment. So I couldn't have asked for anything better than this. Brave, shooting stars at the Phantom. Passenger and double loss, throwing tantrums. Tell floors, take your heels off at the mansion. Bags to Atlanta. Yeah, I mean, I grew up in a small city, East Palo Alto, California. City is a 2-mile radius, so it's a small town. But you know everybody, everybody's your cousin. You guys may know Devonte Adams, he's from there. So just making it out of there was amazing. So, just so grateful. Take a trip, let's go send some shots. We the reason citizen that why they send a I know his family knows mine, but not my cousin. I didn't put in overtime. for me, getting my hands on the ball is the number one thing, especially me transitioning from receiver to DB. I like having the ball in my hands, so any chance I get, I'm just going after the ball.
Congratulations, cuz!
I can't even.
I got to hug my grandson. Nahshon, of course.
Yeah.
Boy, God damn, you did it! You did it! Shit! Oh, God damn it.
I knew that shit was going to happen.
Yeah.
Oh, and Ray going to be right behind him and AJ. Oh, man. Oh. EPA, we in the house, baby. We in the house.
Me and bro run the city, we just like Ghost and Tommy. White diamond, straight out of Houston, like I went with her Bobby. Don't like to eat out in public, we order takeout. Cover nights, I had to stake out. Went inside because of Jake's out. Fuck a good, we never make out. We was causing
violence, turning shit atrocious. People are requesting money from me.
Who got that? Who got it?
I ain't got paid yet. Hold this from you, Domo. Shout yourself out. Bruh.
Y'all go follow me.
Bruh.
Homeowner Damo, you know.
Yeah.
My main brother.
Bruh, where the bottles at? I'm about to pop a Bel Air. I don't even drink. But I ain't drinking it though. I'm just gonna pop.
Nah, because remember I was shopping.
Well, mama. Come on. Just shut up. We popping it on him?
Yeah, yeah, we got popping on him.
Hey!
Let's go!
Look at him. Hit your greedy, brother!
He said what?
Hey! There you go! DeAndre,
good kill, dog. We going to Dallas with it, though. Not playing.
Yes, sir!
Nigga!
Nigga! Quit playing with us, nigga. We really getting paid out here. The right way. You cried?
Nah.
Nigga, I cried, nigga. I cried for you on my mama idea.
Y'all know how we doing? We to Dallas with it. Y'all know how we coming? We really to Dallas with it. Brother back to back. Yeah. No lie. And then his little brother, little cousins are gonna kick the door down. He paid away. Dream team. He's from Alto, California. Yeah, shout out Shawnee.
Members
putting on for good.
Members.
RP Wall, all that.
Demion, big runs. Big runs, Demion.
Big runs.
Big runs.
Look,
number 10 next. Number 10 next. They got number 88 next. number uno or number 7. You know how I'm doing it. Shit, number 10 again.
We got the rapper.
Rap.
We got the rapper.
We deep in here, I'm telling you.
80,000 right here.
Hey, success. Mercedes-Benz. Like, it's just success on success. Like, shit.
We got DeAndre Forks behind the camera, man. We got everybody.
I'm telling you, nigga. No spoon, nigga, fork.
No spoon, nigga, fork.
Savage shit. Savage shit.
Hey, man, we just want to see all our family members eat, nigga.
Yes, sir.
You been back with them, huh?
I'm gonna push him in the pool. I'm gonna push him in the pool. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna push him in the pool. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it. Fine, I won't do it. I won't do it.
Proud of you, man. I wish your dad was here.
I found that nothing in life is worthwhile unless you take risks. Nothing. Nelson Mandela said, "There is no passion to be found playing small and settling for a life that's less than the one you're capable of living." Now, I'm sure in your experiences in school and applying to college and picking your major and deciding what you want to do with life, I'm sure people have told you to make sure you have something to fall back on. Make sure you got something to fall back on, honey. But I never understood that concept, having something to fall back on. If I'm going to fall, I don't want to fall back on anything. I want to fall forward. I figure at least this way I'll see what I'm going to hit. Without consistency, you'll never finish. So do what you feel passionate about. Take chances. Don't be afraid to fail. There's an old IQ test was 9 dots, and you had to draw 5 lines with a pencil within these 9 dots without lifting the pencil. The only way to do it was to go outside the box. Don't be afraid to think outside the box. Don't be afraid to fail big, to dream big. But remember, dreams without goals are just dreams.
My name is Sadia Simon. I am Nahshon Wright's mother. My draft predictions for Nahshon was always third round pick. I even had a couple of coworkers and friends that all felt the same. I had already heard that teams were looking at him as a third round. So I didn't think it would go any further than the fourth round. But for the most part, my prediction was third round. I predicted maybe another team, you know, jumping ahead and getting them, but that would have required, you know, second round. But the team that really wanted them did what they had to do, and they got them, which is what I predicted. I always felt that it was going to be the Cowboys.
Technically, it's Kari's fault that I'm late.
I be running the night bus right now.
Are you?
VIP, that's what we're doing today for my grandson, Nahshon Wright, number 40. It's showtime, bring it, right? That's what it says on the back of the shirt. You gotta bring it right.
I think it's important for children to have the support from their parents with anything that they want to do. Can't do it on their own. Sometimes it's emotional, and a lot of times it's financial. So if a parent thinks it's more important to go hang out or go, you know, buy the latest and the greatest things as opposed to investing that in their children, they can only go so far. So I think mothers, especially mothers, there are a lot of fathers that do because they just like sports, but a lot of kids really enjoy their mom being there too, seeing them cheering them on and things like that. So I think it's really important for mothers to be there as well. Ever since the draft and even before, but more so now after the draft, I've been really, really busy with trying to support him in his career, in addition to also supporting his younger brother, Rajon, as he continues in college. I really didn't realize there was a lot of adversities for Nahshon because the way that he is, kind of quiet about things. he speaks up for himself. He takes up for himself. But as far as being down and going through things and trying to accomplish his goals, he's pretty quiet about it. He just does what he has to do. Some adversities, I would say, may have been losing his father, not being able to be there to see him go to college and fulfill his dream and what he wanted to do. The success coming out of East Palo Alto is long overdue. We have soccer players who are my two cousins. They go to Cal Berkeley. We have Makai Blackman, who's at Colorado. We have Nahshon Wright, Rayshon Wright, who went to Oregon State. We have Troy Franklin, who's with the Oregon Ducks. We have Jeremiah Irby, who will be also going to Cal Berkeley. We have Devontae Adams with the Fresno State. We have Jordan Mims. We have a lot of talent that is long overdue. And I attribute the success to the parents. So we, unfortunately, didn't have those same opportunities. I don't think people even bothered coming to East Palo Alto considering the crime rate and the things that was going on there. So if you're not looking there, you don't know that there's diamonds in the rough. I'm happy that the success of Devontae Adams and Keyshawn Johnson opened the door to other kids that are just as talented to come up after them, and the world to recognize that there's more to East Palo Alto than the stories of murders and things like that. For it to be such a small city and to have all that talent there says that there was always talent there, and that it just needed to have the opportunity for people to see what we could do. And so I'm really happy that that's happening and people are becoming successful and going after their dreams and actually being noticed for them. It's unfortunate that it's taken our kids for the world to see. But from this point on, I don't think we'll ever have a problem with people knowing about what we have in that little town. Regardless of the stereotypes with our people, that there is substance. And it just take support.
Ride when I'm top, my Glock, it ain't no safety.
It's loose! And the Cowboys are gonna get this one, maybe in the end zone!
Instagram DC over here, only time you wanna be something.
They got it! Still no signal for a touchdown, but it's gotta be! I never saw a touchdown signal, even though he came out of it in the end zone. It was certainly close. Nahshon Wright. It goes past the line, Wright hits it, Denver recovers, changed the whole trajectory of the game. This time, punt block, Wright recovers for a touchdown, and we get a penalty. And by the way, it's 35-3 in the first half.
Yards,
first down, 48, and
Wright
two,
Nahshon
Wright.
Oh, you didn't know that?
Uh-huh.
Oh, he bought that on Saturday when he was up in Oregon.
Like my new car.
Nice. Nice.
Boo.
Hi. You and your camera. Hi, DeAndre.
Hi. Yeah. Tune in. This right here, not even out yet. So, just saying, you know, NFL, you need to get some. We need to get some things done. You know, talk to us. We get the prices right for you, and we do some business, man. That's what we need to do. Gotta stick together. You and us. We and you. You know what I'm saying? You see it? Recognize the gang. Appreciate you.
My day-to-day living since he got drafted is that a lot of people, more people come up to me and acknowledge a lot of people remember me from Netflix. So it changed me, being on Netflix. It made me just respect what he done more. It made me proud. The fact that, like I say, he's my grandson. Oh, I'm doing okay, man. I'm sitting there being interviewed. Did it get on that? It rang? Well, they make me seem like I'm important. Come on, dude. Let that ring stay there. Yeah. Leave that in there. What's going to be next? And I want everybody to see this coming. Lo and behold, everybody better watch out for Ray and AJ. They're going to be the next one come out. So everybody just hang on to their feet and just watch it. Ray and AJ.